Whenever I write a letter of recommendation, I like to sit down with students and ask them several questions. And one of my favorites is, what are you going to remember about organic chemistry in 10 years from now? I really doubt that you'll be able to remember how to write complex reaction mechanisms or what are the frontier orbitals involved in some elementary step. But what I do hope you take away from this class is the idea that at its core, the chemistry that takes place in biological systems is really fundamental organic chemistry. And hopefully this idea is borne out in webcast 32 and in 33, where we're going to be looking at some elimination and isomerization reactions. Where we're heading with this in webcast 33 is to be able to look at a fairly complex biosynthetic pathway, the biosynthesis of the aromatic amino acids. And it's here that the herbicide Roundup gets involved. Roundup's active ingredient is glyphosate, whose structure is shown here, and it's an inhibitor of one of the enzymes in this step. So before we can get to that, we need to understand how it is that nature performs elimination reactions, and hopefully what you see is, at its core, organic chemistry. So if we remember about anything about elimination reactions, and if that the elements that we're trying to eliminate are water, say a hydroxide group from an alcohol, well, we know that we have a pretty poor leaving group because water, the conjugate acid of the leaving group, hydroxide, has a very low acidity. It has a pretty high pKa, meaning it's a very weak acid, and we would like to be dealing with not strong bases as leaving groups, but weak bases, because the weaker the base, the better is the leaving group. And the hydroxide is simply too strong of a base to be a very good leaving group. Now, we know a couple of ways around this dilemma. One is we know we can do elimination by beta elimination, and that hydroxide would be an acceptable leaving group. And the other thing we know that we could do is to convert that hydroxide into a better leaving group. Well, nature's choice of converting that hydroxide into a better leaving group is phosphorylation. And here you see in a step in terpene synthesis, isoprene synthesis, this hydroxyl group can be eliminated by converting that into a phosphate. So compared to 15.7, which is the pKa, the conjugate acid of hydroxide, the pKa, the conjugate acid of phosphate, is 7.2. And so that's a much weaker base. Phosphate is a much weaker base than hydroxide. And so we've improved the leaving group ability quite a bit. And in this case, there's a decarboxylation. You can follow the curved arrows. Decarboxylation that gives rise to the formation of a double bond, which is usually what we're looking for in elimination reactions, the formation of a double bond. So decarboxylation, double bond formation, and the loss of the leaving group phosphate. So in the upcoming webcasts, we're going to be looking at what are the mechanisms involved, and here we just see why it is that phosphorylation is often one choice in order to execute an elimination reaction.